Good morning, and welcome to St. Mark's, as today we celebrate the ninth Sunday after Pentecost. Our color continues to be green, symbolizing our new life in Christ. We call your attention to the ministries, events, and meetings that will take place this week and beyond, especially the details concerning price, payment, and contact information for our sight and sound bus trip. They continue to appear in your bulletin, and I call your attention to the August 13th deadline. Please add to our prayer list this morning, Charlotte Writes. Again, Charlotte Writes to our prayer list. Do we have specific announcements that we'd like to share with one another? If not, I would ask if you would please stand as you are able.
Thank you.
your Son, you bring us into your kingdom. By the Spirit, give us your wisdom and wisdom that comes from Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Those whom he foreknew, he also caused to be conformed to the image of his those whom he justified, he also glorified. When then are we to say these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, he will not with him also give everything else. Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Is it Christ Jesus who died? Yes. Who was raised? Who is at the right hand of God? Who indeed intercedes for us? Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are counted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Say again.
As we have seen in these last 3 weeks, as we encounter the five parables for today, parables often leave us with more questions than answers. They are not tiny little sayings and facts that we can tie up all nice and neat with a big red bow. Parables tell us not only what the kingdom is like, they also reveal to us what Jesus is like. The ways in which Jesus comes among us. How in the small, the unexpected, the unpredictable, the illogical, we are likely to find the presence of Almighty God and the kingdom in our midst. Parables teach us that the kingdom is that which we cannot control. The kingdom shows up. We don't know where, we don't know how, but the kingdom comes among us. We are asked to merely acknowledge it, embrace it, and strive to live in it. And so, says Jesus, the kingdom is like a mustard seed. Tiny, small, unnoticeable. And yet, when it comes into its own, it's everywhere. You can't miss it. It becomes both a tree and a shelter. The kingdom is like yeast that a woman mixes with flour to make huge amounts of dough. In Jesus' time, yeast was something you had to make. There were no convenient packages of dried yeast that you could go and purchase at the grocery store, let alone took time. It was done by letting some bread rot just long enough. And then you took the leaven from the old and you added it to the new. The kingdom, according to Jesus, comes from something unwanted that God makes into something good. While you even get the image of rising from the dead. The kingdom is like a treasure hidden in a field that makes a person sell all our possessions in order to buy that field. When we hear that, we ask, why not just take the treasure with you? It is like a pearl of great price that makes the merchant sell all other pearls just to have that one pearl. The value of the kingdom cannot be overestimated. It is to be so desired that one is willing to sell everything in order to possess it. The kingdom is like a net thrown into the sea that catches all varieties of fish. The good fish are those who are faithful to God. The bad fish are those who choose to be their own God or choose to worship what they will, what they want. The good will be distinguished from the bad on the day of judgment by God. So for now, all of us should seek to be faithful, should seek ways to show love to one another. In these parables, Jesus is telling us that the kingdom is of God. While earthy, and to some extent can be understood, it is not earthly. Like grace, we do not manufacture it. We do not bring it about. The kingdom is a gift. God's gifts are unexpected. But like all gifts, they ask for a response. Are we willing to respond? Are we willing in a way to say thank you? To cherish and to use the gift we have been given? Are we willing to recognize the power in the small? How one idea or one word can can change everything. Are we willing to embrace the concept that from what we consider to be junk can become desirable, even a blessing? Are we willing to see our treasure as having more value when it is sacrificed, when it is given up for the greater good? Are we willing to conceive the kingdom as a blessing more to be desired than all of what life holds dear? Are we willing to proclaim that all of us have the potential of being good or being bad, and that God sorts out the details? Eternal judgment is left to God and not to us. Experiencing the kingdom, living in the kingdom, is all about trusting God, praying for wisdom like Solomon, being comforted by the truth from Paul, who in the letter to the Romans writes, "If God is for us, who is against us?" Jesus is teaching to trust God, the God that uses the insignificant, the God that uses what others call unusable, the God who calls us to love others with reckless abandon, the God that sees in us and in others what the world mocks and cannot see. When we live in this way, we become part of what God has brought to us, part of what breaks into our world, the kingdom, where the wisdom of God and the way of Jesus become our greatest treasure. Amen.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Confident that God receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers to the Church and those in need and all of creation. Almighty God, we pray for the Church and all servants of the gospel. Equip ordained and lay ministers to proclaim that nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, we pray for the well-being of creation. Safeguard the environment. Clean polluted rivers and lakes. Preserve the mighty tree and the tiny mustard seed. And send advocates for sustainable practices. Hear us, O God. Instill in all who govern the ability to discern between good and evil. Free those who are oppressed and protect those facing danger. Promote peace across the world, in our towns and in our neighborhoods. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Merciful God, we pray for all in any need. Protect those fleeing from war. Shelter any who are in poverty. Clothe the naked, soothe all who grieve, and heal the sick, especially Liz, Grace, Diane, Vanessa, Gary, Charles, Jerry, Patricia, Diana, Richard, Ashton, Lucille, April, Ruth, Gary, Elsie, Virginia, Susan, Bunny, Judy, Ezra, Sheila, Kevin, Kathy, Micah, Steve, Deb, Linda, Dick, Marianne, Charlotte. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Holy God, we pray for this congregation, both those gathered today and those absent from our assembly. Grant safety to travelers and refreshment and safety for children attending summer camps or community programs. Give direction to any experiencing life transitions. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Eternal God, we give thanks for all your saints who now rest in their labors. Inspire us by their witness to treasure the gospel and continually nourish us with your grace. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, in the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. through Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection, opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join in unending hymn. Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Share.